Well, the film is called Let's Talk, and it has a wife who's pregnant, and the baby may not be her husband's, and she's wondering how her husband will react. What will he do when she breaks the news to him? And in her mind, she imagines many different possible reactions. She imagines whether he will get depressed, or will he get angry, or will he get violent, or will he forgive her? And so it has the many different possible reactions to this one situation. The film is also based on the form of a Thumri, because in Thumri music you can sing one line in many different ways. And the Thumri therefore is there as part of the music in the film. And also there is an album coming out which will have seven songs inspired by the movie and one song which is there in the movie. But they're all Thumris done in a contemporary kind of manner. Okay? This is a digital film. It's probably India's, I don't know, maybe it's India's first digital to 35 movie. And the fact that a movie like this, which is, it's, in many ways it's a small movie, can get theatrical distribution in today's age is, I think, hats off to Shringar. Also, though it's shot in digital, it shouldn't matter to the audience what it's shot on. Because it doesn't, as long as they get involved in the story, it's okay. I don't think that it's a question of mainstream cinema. I think there are many different kinds of cinemas, as there are many different kinds of India. And so you make films for different target audiences. The music of the music is the Thumri, and it's done in a world contemporary fusion kind of manner. Ram Sampath is the person who's done the music for it. And though it is part of our roots, but we have made it contemporary.
So what do you have to say about the actors?
Well, Baman Irani, I think, is one of our finest undiscovered talents. After this film, he'll get discovered. Maya Katrak was somebody who was the scriptwriter, and this is her first time that she's acting. I think they've both done some wonderful performances.
So finally, what are the expectations?
We've already sort of gone beyond our expectations. We've had feedback, and we have had people who've liked the film so much that we already feel that we have sort of achieved a lot. Thank you.
To my mind, one of the most conceptual and intellectual music directors that I have ever worked with. And he's also possibly one of the most creatively honest music directors that I've ever worked with. Thank you, Ram, for not losing the soul of the Thumri. I'm going to get Ram to say a few words to you.
One thing that really strikes me is that this whole project is, we want to just help you find the courage to go out there and actually record the people. The process was great fun. I traveled across the country backpack with a DAT player.
Actually, the music of the film is where we come from. Really, we believe that a film shouldn't have more music than it actually needs. So the film's music is just essential to the film. It's got only one song, and it's called Balamba Tum Kya Jaano Preet. It's sung by Zarina Begumji from Lucknow. But besides that, the film's got music in its transitions, and in its structure, music is interwoven because the film is structured like a thumri. I don't know whether these experiments will work or not, and it's definitely not the first time that a thumri has been used in a film. But I think the unique part of this is that the very fact that the film doesn't cater to the conventional forms of say a Bollywood film, where it doesn't have a lot of songs in it, it just has one song. But the unique thing really is that the album has songs inspired from the film. They are not in the film, but they're inspired by the film. And we're going to follow them up with music videos that are going to come on the channels, which are going to represent the album as an independent entity besides the film itself. So that'll be the unique part. The fact that Thumri has never been seen in a modern context, that in itself is a unique thing. Yeah, I think I had the most fun during the process of the album, which is basically I traveled around the country and recorded singers that I worship. I think the process of recording the album was the most fun part of the entire journey. because I just traveled across the country. I went to Banaras, Lucknow, Kanpur, Patna, Calcutta, and we recorded some parts in Bombay with Aruna Sairam. That was the most fun part because I used to just go and request these people to sing for me, these great, great singers, phenomenal singers, great classical and folk singers, whom the mainstream has no awareness of. The mainstream doesn't seem to give them a platform. I was just hoping that in some way these people could be heard by a more mainstream audience.